or what we need to accomplish in the future. In it, they have four goals. I think they're spot on, and you'll see a lot of themes in the four goals that resonate here at Marlin over and over and over again. Of course, best places to manufacture. We're big into that. We make everything here. We import nothing. Expanding access to clients. Our second biggest order this month is to Japan on our brand new machine. So things like the trans-Pacific partnership really help us, okay, because we're going to be able to sell more to Japan, hopefully, and other countries in the Pacific area. We've shipped soon after we secured the deal with Colombia in the recent free trade agreement. We shipped a large run to Colombia, all made here in Baltimore. We actually export to 36 countries, all made right here. Skilled workforce, that's the key to us. And why? Because our employees are so intrinsic to the success of our company, and they make us great. They make us different. Our people are paid more than what they're paid in China or Malaysia or Thailand. So we have to offer something different. And so the skilled workforce, all three is critical. R&D, 25% of Marlin's employees are mechanical engineers. We're constantly investing in innovation. It's not a theoretical inside Washington, MIT, Harvard kind of chatter. It's real. We're not innovating. We're not coming up with the newest, greatest stuff. Why use us? You go with the cheap guy, right, in China. So those four goals that are in this book are so spot on and really resonate here at Marlin. It's critical to our success. You guys are fighting a good fight, and it's imperative that you win. Let me tell you a little bit about Marlin. I bought the company in 1998. The company was 30 years old when I bought it, and we made commodity bagel baskets. Bagel baskets for little bagel shops throughout America. And I don't know if you guys remember, in the 90s, bagels were like that. Everybody was buying bagels like crazy. It was the thing they would buy. Very commonplace in America. And so I bought the company right around that time, and I thought I was a genius because, you know, everybody needs bagel baskets. You don't need six bagel shops in Akron, Ohio. You need 60, you know, and I thought we were just going to grow right to the moon. Well, I was really surprised when two terrible things happened for our company. The first one was the Atkins diet. I don't know if you guys remember the Atkins
diet.
It's a really bad place to position your bagel basket manufacturing. It was devastating because everybody stopped eating carbs, carbohydrates. So that was really ugly. The second bad thing that occurred was China. They started bringing in bagel baskets for cheaper than I could buy steel. So basically, we had an untenable market proposition. We had a situation where every single basket I sold, we were underwater from our competitors. So forget about the chrome plating, forget about welding, forget about insurance, forget about holiday pay, vacation pay, rent, secretary in the front office, all that. Couldn't make it work. So we had to morph. And around that time, we were very fortunate. We got a phone call from an engineer at Boeing. This is the transformational story for us. And he asked us for a handful of baskets of a certain dimension, a certain size, and we need them really quick. So I said to myself, this is going to be a pain because when I sell to, you know, Einstein bagels or Brubakers, and we're selling 1,000 or 2,500 at a time, only in six. And I said to myself, I'm going to have to charge you twice as much as I normally charge. And he said, yeah, whatever. That was my epiphany, okay? That I have to focus not on the commodity market, where they don't care about quality, where they don't care about whether or not it's going to last a long time. I had to focus on three things: quality, engineering, and quick. If I do quality, engineered, quick, good things will happen tomorrow, because there's people out there that appreciate those three things. So we've morphed the company, and we've changed from a commodity player to a company that's focused on these three things, and these three things saved the company. So to kind of give you a perspective, when I first bought the company, we're talking about engineering, this was my bill of materials the day I bought the company. This is our intellectual property the day I bought the company. So if we wanted to make an 18 by 26 by 4 basket, I would look at this little piece of paper and figure out that we needed a 34 and a quarter inch long wire, and we needed a quantity of 11. We would need a 26 and a half inch basket, 26 and a half inch long wire, and 17. This is how I would do our intellectual property when they bought the company. So this is actually a little bit of a anecdote for American manufacturing in general, okay? there's kind of a bifurcation of what's happening. The guys that are working with this level of intellectual property, okay, are going the way of the dodo. They're going away. Okay, the guys that are transforming are all of a sudden making it, and that's the manufacturing renaissance you hear about, because they're migrating to what people care about. They're not commodity. They're doing those kinds of things. So now we're making baskets that are focused on engineering applications that are unique and different and fast. So we ship very quickly. We have really innovative engineering, and we ship with great quality. It's with great quality. These are baskets that have been shipped to 36 countries right here. Senator Mikulski was here when she saw us ship these to China, and Secretary Geithner was here when we shipped these to Mexico. So we've come a long way from the day of selling bagel baskets, knife-type bagels. The last couple of years have been really good. We've been growing 6 years in a row, revenue growth and profit growth. Last month, we found out, and we're honored, we were in the Inc. 5,000. We're number 4,112 fastest-growing company in America. 162 manufacturing. So we're really proud of that. There's 223,000 manufacturers, so being number 162 is a big deal for us.
Yeah.
We also, in March, we were honored to be in the Inner City 100. That's the fastest 100 growing companies in the inner cities, with New York, Philly, LA, etc. There's only six of us who are manufacturers. So we're really proud of that. So now we do things like sheet metal, like this is for Hewlett Packard right here, that goes into server rooms. We do things like still wire baskets, but now we might have a sheet metal element added to it. We're also doing milling. Things like this is holding laser, this is a laser housing, and lasers get shot out of here. So we're doing four axis milling. So the company's really changed since when we bought it. The newest piece of equipment today I bought it was from 1950s. Okay? And the employees were paid $8 an hour. The health insurance plan was you go to the emergency room. There was no 401k plan. So you're going to see a very different company today. And we're going to take a little walk around. So why don't we start, we're going to head towards the engineers. And then we'll go back out to the back. Here's a couple different baskets and racks we made from BAE, this is military. Eaton, a lot of these are NAM members.
Right.
Eaton, Merck, which is pharmaceutical.